guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. My name is Harshita and in today's video, I'm going to be busting some myths that people have about the qualities of being a good lawyer. All of this will be based on my opinions and my experiences in my 2 years of law school. So without further ado, let's get to it. The first perception that people have about being a good lawyer is that you must have debated and participated in a lot of MUNs in your school life. Well, in my opinion, if you do not debate or participate in MUNs in your school life, it does not affect the kind of lawyer you're going to be. In my personal experience, I had never debated or participated in any MUNs in my 14 years of schooling. I had never stood up in front of people to argue or to speak. Even though debating and participating in MUNs provides you with a lot of advantages as compared to your other friends, it is not something where you base your law career on. Even if you've not debated, it does not mean that you cannot develop this skill throughout your law school and through practice. Not participating in any debates or MUNs in my school life did give me a lot of disadvantage because I did not have a lot to put on my CV so as to be inducted into societies in the college. The first semester of law school was a little tough for me because I did not have any prior experience. So that is one thing that might give people who have debated an edge over people who have not. Participating in such competitions does give you a lot of confidence and exposure since your childhood, and it does help a lot when you're trying to put your point out there. So in my experience, in my first semester of law school, I was shy and less confident to speak in class or to speak in front of people because I did not think I had the confidence in me to go up there and talk. However, throughout my 2 years of law school, I did build a lot of experience and skills in debating. We had moot courts in class that helped me get a hang of what debating actually is. Even though I had no experience in debating, I did build it in my law school and I got through my moot court society. I also represented my college in the national moot court competition and won it. During my moot court competition, not having a debating background did affect me because I was not that confident that I could speak properly and help my team win. However, someone with a debating background at that point would have been a little more confident than me and would have gotten an edge over me. In short, if you have not debated, that does not mean that you cannot be a good lawyer or that you cannot take up law as a career. It does give you a little disadvantages in terms of experience and exposure, but it is something that you can develop and build throughout law school and get better at. Not debating does set you back, so it's better to have some experience from school, but the failure of doing so is not at all something that refrains you from taking law as a career. Second, people think that good lawyers are only the ones who can fight and argue well, and the people who are soft-spoken will always be pushovers and will not be able to go any further. However, this is not at all true. Even though you need to be a good arguer, most important thing is your communication skill. If you can communicate well by being soft, that does not mean that you cannot be a good lawyer. Communicating is the most important thing in law. You need to put your point forward, and to put your point forward, you need not always be the loudest or the most aggressive person in the room. Contrary to being a good fighter, I think negotiation would be a better skill. The people who are smart and know how to make their way out can be the ones who can be good lawyers. Being a good listener is also an important part of being a good lawyer. You do not always have to argue. You need to listen to what the other person is saying so that you can understand and comprehend what the other person wants. Third, people think that the people who want to become lawyers need to be very good at lying. Well, I don't think so at all, because a case is always argued on the basis of facts and case laws, and there is no room for lying. If you're caught lying, you'll be liable for punishment, and I don't think people want to do that. 4. People think that good lawyers are the ones who have the habit of reading a lot. Well, I'm not going to disagree with that at all. If you have the habit of reading, you will always have an edge over your competitors. In law school, we do have to read a lot so as to keep up with everything that's going on. Understanding the different sides of law, the different perspectives of law, and what the different scholars have written, you need to read a lot. The people that have the habit of reading can read much more in a very less time. Personally, I feel that a person who has the habit of reading can become a better lawyer because they might know more things in comparison to the other person. 5th, people think that having a legal background is of utmost importance to be a good lawyer or to read somewhere. I'm not going to deny to that fact. Having a legal background does give you a lot of edge, be it in internships or job opportunities. It has only been 2 years in law school, and there have been moments I have felt disadvantaged because of the fact that I'm going to be a first generation lawyer and that I have no legal background whatsoever. There are points where I have to work much, much harder to simply get an internship. So yes, it does make a difference. But at the same time, I also feel that if you are hardworking and if you are determined, then no one can stop you from being a good lawyer. There are so many first generation lawyers who have made a difference and who have been successful. So just because you do not have a legal background does not mean that you should decide against choosing law as your career. So these are the 5 myths that I think people have, some being true, some not being true. If you're aware of any other perceptions that people have about being good lawyers, please put it down in the comments. I'd love to know what you feel. I'd like to repeat that everything that has been said in this video is totally based on my experiences and my opinion. It is totally okay if you disagree with. I'd love to know your point of view on it, so please do put it in the comment section. So that's about it for this video. If you guys enjoyed watching it, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.